Hi there, everyone. So what I want to do is just to explain again in a little bit more detail how you could go about analysing your James Bond song in detail. And I'm going to use From Russia With Love as an example. This is the one that I've looked at. First of all, you'll need the PowerPoint in order to type into the slides, plus also any other resources that might be useful. So in this case, that is by going into Teams and going up to the meeting notes that we made from a lesson. But it might be that and you can see the example here. These are meeting notes that we made that will help you. But it might be that I've given you a different sort of handout to do this, like a Word document or something like that, as well as needing my PowerPoint to do this. Okay, so just to remind you that the first thing we're starting off with is the genre and context of the song. So I'm just going to talk you through how you do this. This is a slide to fill in. You can see I've already filled some bits in. So the first thing is that the song and the composers and the singers and everything are all in this slide here, which is all hyperlinked. So hold control down, click on the link, and it'll take you to a Wikipedia page about that. So that's what I've done to look up some information about Matt Monro, because I didn't know a lot about him before I started on this. He is the singer of From Russia With Love. He's a baritone singing voice, and he's popular in the 50s to 70s, and he's singing this sort of crooning style. So this is sort of like, you know, like almost like a swing, sort of a hangover from the swing era in the 1930s and 40s. And he also, because I've done my research here and read the Wikipedia page properly, he also sang the theme tune for another really famous film from the 1960s called Out of Africa. So the original song was actually called Born Free, and the soundtrack for Out of Africa was written by John Barry. He is the song, he's the song composer and the soundtrack composer for From Russia With Love. You could then go on and talk about the other people who were responsible for the songs, so John Barry and Lionel Bartar, the composer and songwriter and lyricist for this song. I'm not going to say anything about them here because several of you have got them to do as an example in your song, and I don't want to give you too many points. You've got to go and look it all up for yourself. So the first thing to do is this genre and context. Just look up a little bit about it. Get the song playing in the background while you're reading, just so you listen to the song again. Okay, what I've done then is I've then started on my instrumentation. So I'm using any notes I've made already. And what you can see here is that I've talked about some specific instruments, and then I've also made some notes about what the role of that instrument is. Okay, so just to have a little look through, I'm not going to read all of these through. You can see the sorts of things I'm mentioning. But I'm trying to make some points about it. So I'm not just listing them, I'm trying to show how or where they're used. So there's lots of sweeping strings, pizzicato bass. So I've listened to the fact that it's been plucked. I've not just written down double bass. There are some brass chords, but they're only used occasionally in this song, not like a lot of Bond films where there are loads of like big brass moments. There's piano right hand arpeggios that are used as well, so on and so forth. So try, write a list of these instruments that you think you can hear, some specific things, and then try and tell me something about what their job is in the song. Okay, following that, my song here is dead easy in terms of its structure. It's only really got three main sections following the intro. Some will be more complicated. So this will make this song in ternary form, section A, section B, section A. So I could then put that in the little heading at the top. So this is ternary form. You can see that I've only got four sections. Not many of the songs will require you to fill the whole thing in. If you're doing Live and Let Die, you're probably going to need this list because it's complicated. If you can't like identify a verse or a chorus, do what I've done here, and that is identify by using the same letter but a subsequent number where sections are similar. So the start of the song where the singing starts, From Russia With Love, is how it kicks off. My A section, the first section of the song, first main section of the song, so I call it letter A. When I get to the next section, it's different, so I give it a different letter, letter B. But then when we get to the end of the song, I can clearly hear it's very similar to the opening. But it's not identical, and that's why I've used A1 here. You can then, you know, keep coming back to the same sections over and over again if you think you can't identify it as a verse and a chorus. So that's another way of doing that. So get your sections listed and then your time codes. Make sure that you can tell me when the section starts or when you think it starts. Some songs might have little link sections in between sections that are short. It doesn't do that here. It goes straight from one to the other. But it might be that you get a short link section in between the verse and the chorus. We might have a pre-chorus, you might have a middle eight, an instrumental, coda or outro. Think about all of the different sections it could be. Okay. Then what I've done is I've thought about these Bond musical fingerprints. So that's going back to this slide here. Okay. I look at the slide here and then I've identified the ones that I think are used. I don't think the original theme ideas really come into this song at all, apart from one little thing which I've just put over here. A lot of Bond songs are in a minor key. It just so happens that this is in E minor, which is the original key of the original theme. But there are several like sort of typical Bond things that are done in this song. So we power ballad, untuned percussion, minor keys, sweeping strings, the counter melodies, triplet crotchets in the vocal line, a light twinkly intro, dotted crotchet, quaver, bass line. So I've tried to list as many of those as I can, and this is where you need to try and find a few. Depending on your song, these lists will look very different. Some of the songs, particularly some of the other earlier ones, are so clearly influenced by the original Bond theme. This list in here will have three or four things in it. I can think of one particular song, I don't want to say which it is, I'll give the game away, which will have hardly anything that's based on any of the Bond songs, because as a song, it's just kind of like out there on its own and isn't really influenced. So you've got to use your best musical judgment here, and you may make mistakes with this, it doesn't matter, but just have a go. I'm just interested in what you can hear. Okay, and then it's on to the musical analysis to like go into real tiny little detail points. Okay, and that's what you're going to do in these slides. And so I'll show you how I've done this. I've done a couple of examples. So the first example I've done here is by using Windows Snipping Tool. On a Mac, I think you press Command 4 to do this. A Windows Snipping Tool, and I've snipped out a little bit of the original song here because I've managed to find the score of it from my folder, which you can click on in Teams here. So if you click on this link, it should open Teams and it should show you the musical scores, the actual printed music that I've got for some of the Bonds. So you can find it from there. If yours isn't there, it's because I can't get a hold of it and you're just going to do it by listening. And if you're doing it by listening, you won't fill in this slide. So with Windows Snipping Tool, what I did was I got the music up and then I opened Windows Snipping Tool. I clicked on New and I cut out a little bit of the music and I pressed Copy. And then I pasted it into the slide. And then I've used one of my shapes here to highlight the bit of the music that I wanted to show you. I've highlighted one bar here. I could have made it like the whole of the bass line here because it kind of more or less does the same all the way through actually. And what I'm highlighting here is this kind of dotted crotchet quaver bass riff. I hear you cry, there is no dotted crotchet in the bass line, sir. Yep, technically there isn't, but that crotchet followed by the quaver rest kind of has the same rhythmic feel where it's going dum, 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 dum. It's that rhythmic feel that I'm describing there. So I describe the technique and the air of Dr. G. Smith. So dotted crotchet, and I should really then put R in brackets for rhythm after that, okay? And then I identify where it happens in the song. It happens pretty much all the way through once you get past the intro. So it starts at 007, no pun intended. It starts at 7 seconds into the song and then it carries on throughout the rest of the song. And then this is the key thing that tells me about your listening skills. I've tried to analyse what it's doing. So it has a regular one bar rhythmic pattern. It doesn't stay exactly the same all the way through the song, but it kind of got that bum, bum, bum feel most of the time. It's usually based on the tonic and dominant notes of the scale. And that underpins the rest of the musical ideas. It kind of sits there underneath everything else that's happening. I've then also repeated something that I identified in my instrumentation slide. It's a double bass playing it, and it's playing it pizzicato, so plucked instead of with the bow. So that's how I would use a screenshot of a bit of the score, which is here, and that's how I do it. So just to reinforce how you do that again, I'll show you that again. I click on in snipping tool, I click new, and then I click on new there, and I drag round the bit of the music that I want to snip out. Looks like that. I then press the copy button, and then I would paste it into the slide. So let's just paste it in, and we're going to end up with two copies here. There it is. This time I've just snipped out just the bass line. I do think it's nice to show what's happening in the rest of the song as well. I don't really mind though, you could do either. Then you can move your shapes over the top of it. Now, a little tip here, if this happens with your shape, the shape's hidden behind the music, click on the music, right click, center back. And that'll let the shape appear over the top of the music. So stop the video, rewind, watch that bit again if you're not sure how to do any of that. Okay, I'll get rid of that out of the way, and I'll move that out of the way there. Use the different shapes, find other shapes that are useful. There are loads at the top of the screen if you want to use those. So if you're going to do a score snip, that's how I'd do it. You'll need to then copy or duplicate this slide several times over, so you can do it about several different bits of the music. I don't just want one of these slides. I would think that you could do me at least half a dozen. Doesn't take long. Now, what happens if you want to get really fancy and you could then illustrate the music by snipping out a bit of audio that goes with it? I'm going to show you how to do that as well. I'm using a website here called Audio Trimmer. There are lots of different online ones that use this, but I'm going to use Audio Trimmer. So bear with, we're going to open up Audio Trimmer. I'll show you how to do this. It's nice and straightforward. Choose your file, wherever you've got it. I'm going to click in here, choose your file. You've got to put it with adverts around the screen, but that's okay. We can live with that. And so I know where I've got my From Russia With Love. It's somewhere in here. Here we go. So here's the song. You can see the audio shape. And all you do is, we want it at 007. So all I do is I drag along to 007 there. And we just need to hear a little bit of it. So I move the other marker here, and the bit in green's a bit you're keeping. And then to make it sound a little bit classy, what I do is I click maybe a fade in and a fade out, MP3 format, and I click crop. And then you click download. And the song will download for you. Go back if it opens up a new page, just click back. It's doing it, and click download again just in case. There you are, and it'll appear. Well, on a Mac it might be different, but it'll appear here. And from there what you can do is you can click the dots and you click show in folder. And there is our clipped bit of From Russia With Love. Okay. From there, back into the PowerPoint, open the folder and just drag and drop. And there you go. You've now provided a little audio cue of your song. So I'd really love people to try this. Have a little listen, press play on it. Listen to the bass line. And you can hear that. Maybe I should have grabbed a bit more of it. You can spend a bit more time carefully thinking about which bit of the music you want to grab. But you could hear the bass going boom, 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 and so on and so forth. One final point. When you're looking at the sheet music I found for you, bear in mind that this sheet music is usually going to be just singer and a piano part, which doesn't necessarily represent the whole song. So if the music sounds slightly different from how it looks in the music, then so be it. Don't worry too much about that. But that's really great if you could illustrate it with a little audio clip. Alternatively, if you can't see the score, so you can't do a score snip, fill in the table like this. So what I've done here is same point, but I've filled it in the table. So 07 onwards, bass riff is a melodic bit of the Dr. G. Smith, is it? Or rhythm? No, it should be rhythmic. What am I doing? It's like that dotted rhythm. So, silly Mr. Moxon. Rhythm. Bassline is a regular one-bar rhythm pattern, and there's my description of it again, which matches. I've just copied and pasted what was there. I've done another illustration. Sweeping violins, melody. Violins play unison melodic phrase, which rises and rapidly falls. And again here, you could grab a bit of the audio out for us. I'm back on Audio Trimmer on the website. I go back to the song. Let's say I just wanted the opening, the intro. There we go. And again, I found it. Click crop. Click download. And here it is. Show in folder. And then drag it in. And if you're going to do several of these, you could have put it next to it. So there's that one there. And when we press play in this should, you should be pressing play. It should just be the intro. We're hearing the sweeping violins. Here we go. And there we are. So I'm looking forward to seeing your analyses of these pieces. It's going to be really interesting to see what sort of features that you find to talk about. And I hope that this instruction video has been nice and clear. So you're going to have an hour in the next lesson to see how far on you can get. And then we'll review that after the hour is up. So thank you, folks. Well done for giving this a go. And I'm looking forward to seeing your analyses. Well done, everyone.